Hey, good morning. So I'm just amazed by this view right now. So currently me and Stefan are in Gardner, Montana, which is literally hundreds of feet, like literally down that way is a sign to get into Yellowstone. So yeah, today we're gonna be, or in this video, or how many videos I make this into, it's gonna be a Yellowstone vlog, whatever. But I'm gonna show you guys this view right now. This is just right out of our balcony right here. And that is just insane. Look at that. So cool. Today is Monday. It's about 7-8 o'clock. We're gonna be here till Friday. We're flying out Friday. But yeah, we're just gonna be exploring Yellowstone, whatever we can. It's currently like 30s. 40s degrees right now. That's why I'm wearing this sweatshirt, but super excited for what the week has in store. I have my coffee here. Horrible coffee. I might just buy somewhere. But yeah, just look at the mountains up there. Wow. Just this entire view is just crazy. I'm gonna try to finish off this really junk coffee, and I'm also continuing to work while I'm here, and I'm waiting for Stefan to wake up so we can get breakfast at that little lodge place right there, the one with the lights. Can't wait to see what happens next. So we looked outside and there are some friends outside. Take a look.
He just stared at me for like a good 5 seconds.
There's one with antlers down there. It's crazy. Wow. It's crazy.
Yes, and it's very cold. For sure. Very, very cold.
Very, very cold. We're here at the Absaroka Lodge.
Oh no.
Oh yeah, from all that elk earlier, there's just poop everywhere. And this is our ride.
Colder, my reflexes are much worse. Oh, this is a barn girl I was telling you last night.
Down there?
There was the deal.
Okay, I'll get the steak.
Okay, go for it.
Can I get the steak and eggs?
Thank you.
Thank you.
We both had it. Like we both had it. Too bad you didn't want it.
Look at that. Let's see if this one's better than the hotel. It's actually bitter. It doesn't taste like water.
Yes, and table sandwich. I'm gonna grab some forks and knives.
Thank you.
Alright.
Wow.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you for this food.
Look at that.
Yellowstone. About to enter. Five for 7 days. Very nice.
This is my first time into a national park. First time. Uno time.
Hi, morning.
What kind of pass would you like?
Private vehicle, please.
All right, so 35. Where are you folks from?
Oh, we're from Texas.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I love Texas.
Yeah, definitely a change of weather. So where would you recommend we go right now? Is it like we're just driving in?
Well, see Old Faithful, check out all the basins there. Mm-hmm. They're beautiful. You can come up, go around the bottom loop to the lake and come up to Canyon.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
and
wow.
You can see
okay.
the waterfalls.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Awesome. That sounds awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good day.
You too.
Nice
thank
to
you.
Meet you.
Thank
nice
you.
To meet
you.
Such a nice lake.
All right, we're officially in Yellowstone. Took a quick stop because I guess we're here. It's so surreal to be here. Isn't that right, Stefan?
Surreal.
But yeah, we have the different kind of wildlife here. We already saw an elk this morning. I really want to see a bison.
Oh, that was a pronghorn that we saw.
A what?
Pronghorn right there. See that?
Oh, this one? Yeah, it looks like a deer. Bighorn. Ooh, bighorn sheep. Look at those. Really want to see a bison though. Oh, we don't have bear spray. If a bear charges you, stand still, do not run. What? Stand your ground and use your bear spray when the bear is 60 feet away or closer. Have them groups three or more. One, two, go.
Cool.
I didn't know we needed bear spray.
I saw it in the gas station last night.
Oh yeah?
What is he doing? Yo! Just go up the trail!
Dude's just really going up there. Again, there's a trail over there. And here. I mean, whatever works, I guess. It's crazy where we are right now. Middle of Montana. In the middle, actually the beginning of November. Ooh, there's a lot of poop here. Step over that. Exploring Yellowstone National Park. 30 degrees. Just can't get better than this. Exactly halfway between the equator and the North Pole. It's crazy. Crazy. In the middle of Montana, who would have known? The 45th parallel of latitude. Views here are insane. That mountain is supposed to be like an inverted C. Not sure how it works, but yeah. It's a lot steeper. Alright, so we're in this little town called Mammoth, but it's really cool because I didn't know, we're actually in Wyoming already. Always wanted to go here, huh?
Sure.
Yeah. So we're at this general store, trying to get a couple things. I kind of have to pee, so let's go. So these are the Mammoth Hot Springs, the terraces.
Oh, down it's a far walk. Let's see how good of internet I have. Well, pretty bad.
This thing is called Liberty Cap.
Liberty be capping here, man.
Sorry. Here at the Pallet Spring. Look at that. Just water, hot spring water, and sulfur. You smell that?
Yeah, sulfur.
Yeah.
Like garbage. I'm hurting my nose.
That's crazy. There's a nice trail that goes around, loops around. Smell that?
Hate it.
Smells like
garbage.
Smells like rotten eggs. Like eggs sitting out for a while. Boy.
Oh gosh.
We're a couple thousand feet up. The elevation is really killing me. Just going up these stairs was tough. Nice, nice. Finished off one of our film rolls. Now I gotta roll it up here. This is really hard to roll up.
Mammoth Hot Springs, it's getting kind of hot, which is pretty crazy. Just trying to roll up the film.
Yeah,
a lot harder than it looks. As you can see, all this view behind us. Elevation pretty high, getting pretty hard to breathe. But, about to head to the next section. Right there is the city of
Mammoth,
I think. Not too sure.
Small town,
very small town. Yeah, people actually live there, which is insane.
Just how to show you what this looks like. This is pretty insane. Doesn't do justice at all. So I zoom in, see the snow over there. It's getting pretty hot, but it's sick.
Are you trying to go on the rock right there?
Going to go on the rock, yeah.
Okay, so he's gonna go on that rock right there.
Look at where we are. Just like. That view, look at the mountain.
And look, over there, there are these rocks there. Pretty like jaggedy, boxy-like. I thought those were houses for a second. And there he goes. He sees the fawn, right there. Get the film cam real quick.
Strike a pose for me, man.
Look at that. Can you see him? Yeah. Spot some bison off the side of the road. That is insane. Those, they're huge. Look, there's one there too.
These bison are huge.
Oh, there's one up there, lying down. If you come to Yellowstone, possibly during this time, it's so quiet. Literally, just cars driving by. Like if I just stop right now. Yeah, there's a car coming, but yeah. You know what I mean. Here at Clearwater Springs. And check it out. Coming up on these. I don't know what you call these, but it's smoking from the ground. Oh, okay, yeah, spring, that's what they're called. Coming up on a spring right now. All right, Clearwater Springs. You just don't see this on a daily basis, you know, just smoke coming out of the ground.
Like bubbling.
Oh, that's crazy. It's bubbling. We hear like this loud, not loud, but it's like,
you can hear it.
It's either steps or something bubbling. I can't tell.
Like, it's like hard, yeah. Though.
Yeah, it does sound like steps. Or it could be just water bubbling.
Yeah. I just don't want it to start charging at us, you know?
Don't worry. We got the Chevrolet Cruise.
Yeah, it's meant to cruise, not get away from stuff, you know?
So you came across this other place here, just driving by. Just look at that. This place is called Roaring Mountain. You know, look at all that steam coming off. It's insane. Wish we could go up closer though. Actually, not really, no. Probably gonna be really hot.
Like, we could definitely make it there for sure.
Yeah,
we could definitely make it. Like, it's not that steep.
Once the climb to this top of the mountain, we can do it.
Hell yeah.
We could definitely
I'm pretty sure we can do it. We probably... Like it. First day, you know? We don't want to do it on the first day.
Not the first day. It's probably gonna be very hot.
It's already steaming.
Yeah, and I'm wearing Air Forces. It's not the best shoes to, you know, climb a whole mountain with, so...
Yeah. These things are called fumaroles. Steam rushes outward through the vents. So those vents up there, fumaroles.
I guess.
All right. Yeah, we're like one of the only people out here. It's so quiet. It's really nice. I bet this place is like packed during the summer. I'm glad we came here during the winter when there's a lot less people. But so cool so far.
Another great view. Look down there, you literally see the water. It's boiling. How hot it is. That's cool.
Oh no, the battery's dying already. Barely did anything today. Trying to figure out where we're going next. We might head down to Norris. He just went across the street. I'm gonna stop in Norris because there's a museum there. It's pretty much just figure out what we're gonna do, because we're planning on going to a hot spring, like one you can actually go inside. But they don't open till Wednesday. So we have today and tomorrow to kill before we do that. We want to go to Old Faithful, but I'm not sure if we actually can because they might close off the path towards there. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. If not, we have this entire loop here that we can basically explore. But yeah, the views are insane here. I don't even know what to say because... I feel like I said enough, just very like repetitive at this point. Alright, we just got to this area called the Norris area. I wonder if Chuck is around.
Oh, Chuck Norris, okay.
Yeah.
I guess so, yeah.
But for today, we're kind of just like scoping out the place. Not really have much planned. We're just driving, yeah. driving.
I've been driving like 30 miles per hour for the past like 3-4 hours.
Yeah.
It's been rolling.
Apparently there's a museum here somewhere. Don't know where it would be though. We're in the middle of the forest. So yeah, we're seeing where the path takes us.
See where the path takes us.
Oh, the museum is closed. Great.
It's literally like 5 things.
Oh. Just kidding. I thought it was something much bigger than that. Oh, it's a long trail. The geyser's all the way down there.
I don't know if you can hear that, but yeah, it's boiling.
See all the steam coming out of there?
Like over there, it's all green. I don't know why. Oh, so the green stuff is algae.
Oh, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, it's algae.
Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
That's crazy. Imagine Old Faithful just.
It's a waterfall.
Old Faithful?
Yeah, it's a waterfall.
I thought it was a geyser.
She said it was a waterfall.
We'll see when we get there.
We'll bet.
Whoever loses,
next full tank of gas.
It's like a soup.
Oh my gosh, it changed colors. It's what? Changing colors.
What's changing colors?
The pine cone.
Because you're boiling it.
Anything else I can do?
Good morning. Don't mind my messy hair. I have a little bit of bedhead, but here, this is day two in Montana / Yellowstone / Wyoming. We're planning on going to Old Faithful, very famous geyser, and like this other place, it's like a Grand Canyon of Yellowstone. So yeah, we're gonna be doing those two things today. A little bit of a late start just because, you know, slept kind of late, but
look at the view. It's just beautiful.
Can you believe that just there are some people who live here just on the daily? Granted, there isn't much to do in this small town of like 800 people, but imagine waking up to this view every single day. Just can't beat that. So yeah, we're gonna be leaving soon and hopefully we can do a lot.
Woo. Hey everybody, I don't know if we started the vlog yet or the day, I think, but I'm starting it. He's in the gas station getting a tour charger. So yeah, this is the only gas station in the whole city. Gas is about $3.60, which is ridiculous, but it's currently, he really took the key. It's about like 37 degrees. We're about to head to Old Faithful and Grand Canyon of Yellowstone. So we'll see you guys there. Ooh, you guys see that snow right there? Can I zoom in on this? Okay, let me just. There we go. Now focus. There we go. Woo, look at that. That's Yellowstone. Iron Horse Bar and Grill. See that brown place with lodging? That's where we ate last night. I mean yesterday for breakfast, but today we just bought, or yesterday we bought like sandwiches to eat in the morning, so. Here he comes.
Ah, there's a big man.
Hi.
Yeah. Did you start the video already?
Slightly.
Oh, really. Cool, because I just started it.
Okay.
All right.
So we just stopped, we just found somewhere. Look how much steam there is here. So much sulfur.
So, stop here?
Yeah, let's stop here. We're about to stop here. There's a whole bunch of RVs. All right, here we go.
Intense, man.
All right, let's see. Let's see what all the commotion's about.
A lot of sulfur here.
Oh my gosh.
Hear that?
Oh my gosh. That's crazy. It's so loud. It's more loud than any of the other ones we've seen thus far.
Oh my goodness.
Yep, it smells really bad though. This is I'm breathing it in through my mouth. I don't know if that's healthy or not. Barrels. Oh man, barrel spring oscillates between 188 degrees and 192 degrees. One of the hottest springs in Yellowstone.
We gotta get out of here.
Yeah, I don't know if that's safe to be inhaling. Maybe, I don't know. See, like all that smoke is coming mainly from that big one right there. It's crazy. How much steam is coming off.
Come to Yellowstone so you can see steam come out of the ground like that, you know?
Look at the scenery here. We Seems very eerie. I think it's kind of just crazy how, like, every single time I've seen this, like, up to this point, it was all, like, you know, man-made stuff, like a jacuzzi or something. But this is literally coming out of the earth. Like, there's no, like, jets or anything under there. It's just straight heat and gases straight from the earth, which I think is just crazy. No way. No way he was just making a TikTok dance here. Oh, and by the way, we're taking a bunch of film pics with this camera. If you want to see those pictures, definitely follow on freeley.explore on Instagram and freeley.
He'll put it right on the top right corner. He will link it.
Yeah, that, or you can listen to what I say, freely.film. Yeah, if you want to check it out, check it out.
A little waterfall down there. This looks pretty calm.
The water looks very clear. Yeah, I can see the bottom. I mean, it's just probably really, really dirty in there at the bottom.
So you can see the bottom.
It's not that cold.
Really?
It's not. It's really not that cold.
Could you jump in?
I mean, yeah, I'd jump in. I would, if I had a chance. For some reason, the branches are sturdy enough, but the tree's not sturdy enough.
The tree can't hold you up?
No.
But the branches can.
It's weird.
On our way to Old Faithful, there's just a bunch of these just random, like, steam vents just everywhere. This is by far the biggest one.
Yeah.
And, like, driving up towards this one, I told Stefan, I was like, if this was anywhere else in the world, I think that something's wrong. Something has to be wrong with all this, all that steam. Look.
And here, just fun fact.
Go ahead.
If Yellowstone erupts, half of America is gone.
Yeah. Because it's a super volcano, right? Or something?
Yeah,
something like that.
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much Yellowstone's like a gigantic
volcano.
And we're just, you know, walking around in it.
And honestly, if it erupts while we're here, oh well, you know? Nothing else we could do.
Yeah, nothing much. We can... That Chevrolet is not going to be able to, like... Not enough horsepower to, like, get us through these mountains, you know what I mean? Pretty sure, like... All the other animals are going to be running. So we're probably going to hit something.
And honestly, on your tombstone, wouldn't you want to put... Burnt by Yellowstone. That's
yeah,
cool.
That's
a cool way to go out.
Look how blue this water is. Oh, look. You can see, like, bubbles down there in the bottom. I'm pretty sure I said this yesterday, but this place is so surreal. Just what we're experiencing right now. All this steam and just random pools of pockets of heat. It's crazy.
This is the... Fountain paint pots. See, it looks like mud, this one. Yeah,
it's
bubbling.
Like really dry, that's why.
It's like big soup. It sounds like soup or a stew or something. Looks like there's a fire. And no, just steam.
This place is called Volcanic Tableland. It's not a very good thing to hear when you're here, but embrace it.
Yep.
If it erupts over here, it erupts. We're donezos. But we got to see it, you know?
Yep. See, this whole span of land right here. See that one? That one's just spewing out liquid. It's the one we saw from afar, and I was like, what is going on?
Really?
Ooh.
old faithful.
Excited!
It's our view currently at the moment.
We're finally here. Is that it? That right there? Can't tell. Seems like a lot of the lodges are closed.
Yes, I know.
And that's where a lot of the food choices are here. Lodges. See, I guess this is something you guys gotta know if you come around this time, like end of October, early November, is that this, like Yellowstone's pretty much dead. I mean, you can still come here, but restaurants, like points of interest will all be closed because they're closed for like a month, right? About a month out of the year. But yeah, so if you decide to come around this time of year, just know that there's not gonna be much open. You'll most likely have a lot of the park to yourself. There's like barely anyone here. But that's the only downside coming around this time. Nothing's open. So you're probably not getting the full, we're probably not getting the full experience right now. If I'm not mistaken, is that Old Faithful? I'm guessing. Because that's like the biggest like mound here.
Yeah.
See, like there's a lodge there. There's a lodge here. They're all closed though. So it's unfortunate. This is a visitor center here. See, this is one of the only visitor centers slash museums or whatever that were open while we're here. We probably came across like two or three. They're all closed.
So you can see there, much of Yellowstone, including the area around Old Faithful Geyser, sits atop an active volcano.
You know, we've been on this volcano for the past couple of days. So according to that like little board there inside, so that Old Faithful's set estimated time to erupt is about 3:20.
Snow Lodge restaurant.
It's about 3 o'clock actually right now. Oh wow, I have internet too. So hopefully we can catch it erupting in the next 20 minutes. But now I'm kinda hungry. I got a bison bratwurst.
Bratwurst.
It's like a hot dog, kind of. Or sausage. It's kind of like a sausage, kind of.
I've been wanting salmon for a while. I don't know why. I think the inner bear in me, you know?
The inner bear in you wanted a salmon burger. So that was Old Faithful. I could say that Old Faithful's pretty faithful. They said it was gonna, you know, do its thing at like 3:20. It was like probably on the dot, like 3:20, 3:21. You know, maybe a minute late, but he's still faithful.
There you are. Oh, it's on the car. Oh, that's messed up. It's a huge bird.
So we're currently headed to where? Somewhere, some little city, but this is our view right now. It is snowing. Yeah, it's pretty cold outside.
Yeah, it's 35 degrees right now, according to the thermostats built into this car. Thermostats,
Chevrolet Cruze. I don't know how much I can trust that, but it's currently snowing and very cold.
Oh, you see it? All right, so we actually just got to our destination called West Thumb. But so the snow caught up to us. Look outside right now. It's snowing. It is literally snowing right now. There's snow getting in the car. I kind of want to bring my camera out there. I don't want to break it. An expensive lens on here too. I guess we're gonna have to switch over just to my phone for now.
I don't even want to go outside.
Yeah, it's all wet now.
Great.
Oh man. Oh, my phone's all wet now. Just got to Grant Village right now. And it looks like there's nothing open. There's a gas station here. There's a visitor center, a general store. And there's just no one here.
Hey, the gas is working though.
It's probably like 450 because we're up in the mountain.
Hey, usually if you put gas in here, that just means you need gas.
Absolutely need it.
No, we're about to head back to a gardener.
I guess we're going to head back to gardener. I guess this is a lesson for anyone coming around this time.
Don't go too far.
Don't go too far, and there's not going to be a lot open. Like, your best bet is to, like, stay around the main attractions, but, like, smaller ones like this, Grant Village and West Dome. Barely anything open. But, hey, it's cool. It's cool we're in Yellowstone for a whole week. Not much people, no crowds. It's a good time. So.
Yeah.
All right, so it's currently 6:47 in the morning. We're headed down to Lamar Valley. At sunrise, all the animals are just like, doing their morning walk and all that stuff. So right now we're heading there. It's about an hour and a half drive. It's super dark, as you can tell from where we are. Like, you never know, there might be like an elk or like a bear that runs in front of the road. But yeah, so we're driving there. It's gonna be a long, dark drive. Quite peaceful. Maybe I should drive down a little bit more that way. Maybe there'll be more action. When it is so cold. Before this bridge right here, the Lamar Bridge or Lamar River Bridge was built. They literally had to go through like that, through the river with the stagecoach. Look down there. That is crazy. Before this was built. And look at that. They would get stuck in the mud until finally they build a bridge. It's just insane to be out here early in the morning. Still the morning mist. Sun's still barely coming up. No one out here too. So cool. Doesn't look like there are any animals out, but still, really nice to be here in the morning. No one here, just the wide open. I found them. Oh, right there.
Stefan's awake, as you can tell.
So we actually came across our bison crossing the road today, and a whole herd of them right now. So many. Well, we can't go until they all cross because, don't want to startle them. Oh, look, is that the baby one you're talking about? This one?
No,
this
one right there.
Oh, this one right there. Oh, yeah, there's a baby bison too. Please don't get any closer to the car.
This is a rental.
Oh my gosh. He's not moving.
Come on, bruh. What's going on, homie?
Now we're at this giant ditch. It's insane. So apparently here in Yellowstone, they have their own little Grand Canyon here. And if you can hear that, there's a waterfall over there. I can't quite see it from this.
Oh, that's straight down. Oh. Trying not to get scared standing here.
Don't fall, please. It's all the way down. Who knew that Yellowstone had its own Grand Canyon?
If I just trip, I was dead.
Yeah. I would have been dead if I tripped. It doesn't seem that scary standing there, but when you look, like, man, I would have been on my way down.
You look right there, there's stairs on the side of the mountain. You go down somewhere. I don't know where it goes.
How does this even happen?
That's what I was asking, too. How?
Like an earthquake, maybe? It is. That's what I'm thinking. Earthquake and it splits.
Grand Canyon of Yellowstone.
It's just straight down from here, but.
Oh my goodness. That's a far drop. Brink of the Lower Falls. The trail is closed, but the overlook ain't. The falls are right there. I got down here before he did, and I had an easier time.
Yeah, yeah, and I used the least amount of energy too.
There's the waterfall, and here's the overlook. He sounds pretty excited. Whoa! No way! Oh, look, there's a rainbow! Whoa, that is crazy!
Rainbow. I like this view too, right here.
Right before the waterfall. Looks so peaceful.
Like this exists here. Like, that's crazy. This is a straight waterfall.
Nice like scenic view right there. This way.
Grand Canyon of Yellowstone. It's so cool. It's huge. Looks like a painting.
Looking down this way, it almost doesn't look real. Just this view that you're looking at, that I'm looking at in person, it doesn't look real at all. But it is. Forward for however long. I think it said 20 miles, 24 miles. Oh, look, there's people. All the way down there on the opposite side of this canyon.
It's probably one of my favorite places we visited here. Won't you say so? This is my favorite place.
It's crazy. This continues on for miles and miles.
Been stopping at like almost every single viewpoint here. I think the view gets a little less interesting every single time. I think the coolest ones were all the way down there. I mean, we're here, might as well stop. Heard someone scream. But when are you gonna be at Yellowstone again, you know? Good morning, everyone, from Yellowstone National Park. So basically yesterday we went down to Bozeman. Spent time in the downtown, walked up and down the downtown street like two or three times because we couldn't decide where to eat. So after spending that time downtown, we decided why not just watch a movie. So we watched that new James Bond movie. Our showing was at 8 and it was at 6 when we bought the ticket. So like we had this 2-hour gap
and we're like, what do we do from here, you know? We walked around the mall. It's a really small town from what we're used to, so there's just not a lot of things to do. So Stefan was like, let me check DoorDash. Maybe there's like promos that we can do. So you open up DoorDash, and next thing you know, we're DoorDashing in Bozeman, like here in Montana. I don't know, for me, it just really fired me up, because I was like, I can't believe we're doing this right now. We're making money while we're technically on vacation. And it was just so cool. I think at the end of the day, there's so many opportunities out there. It's just really up to you, your own self-discipline, and how motivated are you to really make it, you know? It really just comes down to the person. So he was able to pay for his dinner, his movie ticket, and the money that he owed me for, you know, spotting each other here. So I was like, this is crazy. I don't know. It's just really cool. I just want to close out this video with this, you know. It was a great week out here in Yellowstone. It really puts life into perspective, and it really makes you grateful for the life that you live. And I definitely am grateful to be able to see these kind of things. I feel blessed to have the flexibility in the job to be able to do stuff like this, come to places like this. And I don't think I can get tired of this view. If you made this far, congratulations. I don't usually have people to come this far. Like this video, subscribe if you want more videos just like this. And here's to a Yellowstone trip. I'm looking forward to our next one. So thank you guys for watching. God bless.